have put his business. And this opportunity to be in his house, I'm trying to come and learn. That's one thing we're never, you know, reach the point that we can't be taught anymore. I mean, once you have an open heart, that the thing about God is, his mercy is new. Out every morning. That day, every morning, wake up, another day, so every day, his mercy is new.
All right.
And then great. I mean, you have great things and great expectations for us. And as we've been admonished to do, all that we've been taught to wait to seek God, I mean, to worship God and to praise God for who he is and what he's doing. And, I mean, it's just something about, you know, setting the atmosphere in your heart towards God to pray and worship. And, you know, think, I guess, keep reflecting back on that one scripture where they talk about in the Matthews where, you know, like I shared, I think, a couple weeks ago, how the Canaanite woman, how she was able to get what she wanted from the Lord through praise and worship. It was the next thing, like, you know, she just told her no a couple of times. You think in your mind that you can say no when you know. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But in her persistence and what she was believing God for, to heal her daughter, to minister her daughter, she just didn't settle for that. Even it seemed like, you know, I like to call it, it seemed like it was out of season, out of time, one dark point of time. She said, not yet, this is not for you. This meeting for the children, while she was in the house of Israel. That's when I came for. Initially, that's what Jesus' ministry was all about, something about reaching a lost sheep, house of Israel. And that's how we get the opportunity to come, because, you know, Israel, they rejected, the Jews rejected the preaching of the gospel. And that left the door open to us, Gentiles, praise God, to come, praise God, into God's kingdom. And praise God, but in her persistence of seeking God for what she desired for, even though Jesus said, no, this is not for you, this is not your time. And she said, even she said, Lord, even the dogs get the crumbs off the master's table.
Amen.
I mean, her persistence. And that's what we have to be persistent about when we believe in God. Like for the cabin the mission on Monday night by asking God. So many times we think of what God has for us, and it seems like it's so far reach and so far out there. Well, maybe it's not meant for me. Maybe not this is not what God has for me. But I think about the promises and God's word has spoken to us about whatever you might believe in the Father. The scripture says, yeah, yea, and amen, so be it in him.
Yeah.
Praise God. I mean, if you can believe for Hallelujah. He can provide it for you. Hallelujah. The scripture says, do you believe that he is able to do that what you ask him for? Hallelujah. Whether the miracle or healing, these things of, you know, affecting my body that still seem to exist. The doctor said these things are still like that. But what God's word says. Hallelujah. Bible said he paid it. He paid the price. And if he said he'd done it, I believe that he did do it.
Amen.
I believe that's, I think his word is more real than what the doctor's word is. Man, you're just talking your opinion now. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Whom reporters you going to believe? Hallelujah. The Bible said, let every man be persuaded in his own heart. I am totally persuaded that he is able, that he is more than able to keep what you have committed in the Lord. And I have committed my whole life. My body belongs to him. My temple belongs to him. All that I have belongs to him. And so I committed back unto him for his service. These hands, this whole complete body. So I trust in him to keep it well.
Yeah.
Yes, I mean, we have a responsibility to take care of him. Praise God. But yet, we can still trust him through the word of God to believe that what his word says that he's able to do, we'll perform it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. That's why I said I am excited about who I serve. I mean, he's able to provide for us.
Yes.
Praise God. The God of hope, my seed, kind of be going crazy. Hallelujah, my lost money. Hallelujah. Maybe want to feel a little sad and say, oh, you know, hey, you just think it's going to wrap up. But know who you put your trust in. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And when you know who you put your trust in, everything will be okay.
Amen.
Glory to God. I lost some money too. But my trust is not in that. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. I mean, because you got to see people, I mean, they are in fear of what everything is going on. What we all experience, even up to this time. They said the world is just going crazy. Nothing seems to hold up. Nobody, you can put no confidence in anything. But we are different. We have hope. Glory to God. But our hope does not allow us to become ashamed. Praise God. And through that hope in Christ, we can have peace, assurance, and confidence, knowing that our God, praise God, that owns the stock market. Praise God. That own every house, every whatever that is, he owns it all. Our Father, my dad. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. I call it my dad.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And he knows what I have need of.
Yes.
Praise God. He said, I already gave you my his very best. I gave you my son. I'll be with him when he freely give us all things. Glory to God. What a promise.
Yes.
Thank you, Father.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Well, praise God. We see the ministry and brother in the gospel. Praise God. Bless us. We enjoy him on Monday night.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And every time that he comes to Tulsa, we appreciate him so much. And I met him on many Monday nights. He preached the word. He prayed. Praise God. I enjoyed it immensely. Praise God. I enjoyed it every time he comes. And it always means something that it's just amazing how I never knew he talked about asking God how many different areas about asking that he went into. And I don't know how much he'll recap on that, but it's going on tonight. That's what. You got to understand, you got to come where the manna is. I mean, you know, when the children of Israel, when they were out in the wilderness, sometimes when manna was raining, if a group of them was somewhere else, they just pissed out. Sometimes we miss out on things that is benefit for us and encourage us in our walk. Praise God. And we have to be what a man is called. Praise God. And sometimes when there's a word of encouragement to come our way, you need to be in the house to receive that word. So you continue to walk this walk of faith. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So, praise God, without further ado, we'll bring our guest speaker, our brother in the Lord. Praise God, amen. Brother Kevin Collins, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.